In this video, you'll learn about the Safe Mode menu on PS4 systems. If you have a PS4 system that isn't working properly, starting it up in Safe Mode and then executing one or more menu options may help to resolve the issue. First, you'll see how to access the Safe Mode menu, and then you'll learn about each menu option. Use these links to jump to information about a specific Safe Mode option. First, power off your PS4 by pressing and holding the power button for about 7 seconds until the system has beeped twice. Release the power button and wait until the system light shuts completely off. Then, press and hold the power button to turn the PS4 system on, keeping your finger on the button. You should hear one beep when you first press the button, and another beep about 5 seconds later. Release the power button after the second beep. When you see a message directing you to connect a wireless controller and press the PS button, follow these instructions to enter Safe Mode. The first option in the Safe Mode menu is Restart System. This option is used to exit Safe Mode. The second Safe Mode option is Change Resolution. This may help if the PS4 video image isn't showing up on the TV outside of Safe Mode. Select it to restart the PS4 in 480p resolution. If that displays on your TV, then you can go to Settings and Sound and Screen. From there, select Video Output Settings, and then choose Resolution. That's where you can manually select the maximum resolution setting that's supported by your TV. Skip over the third option, System Software Update. If your PS4 cannot start up or update system software normally, then it is recommended that you jump ahead in this video and learn about options 6 and 7. The fourth Safe Mode option is called Restore Default Settings. Using this will change all system settings to the state they were in when the system was brand new. You'll need to sign in to the PlayStation Network afterward, so have the correct email and password for your account on hand. Using this option will not delete any data from your system. The fifth Safe Mode option is Rebuild Database. It's recommended that you try the Rebuild Database option. If your PS4 contains corrupt files which cannot be accessed or deleted, stopped working during a system update, freezes in the system menu, or displays a message after system startup warning that the hard disk drive is corrupted. If your system is experiencing any of these issues, it's a good idea to try the Rebuild Database option. Using this option will not delete anything from the hard disk except for corrupted data. Rebuilding the database may take an hour or longer depending on the amount of data stored on your PS4 system. This brings us to options 6 and 7. These should be used after you've tried other Safe Mode options, but before sending your system in for service. Initialization is a last resort because it will delete all data from the hard disk and reset all system settings back to their factory defaults. If possible, you should back up your saved games and installation data before initialization. Saved game data can be copied to an external USB device, or it can be uploaded to online storage if you're a PlayStation Plus member. Creating a system backup on an external USB device will allow you to restore installed games after a successful initialization. Once data has been backed up, re-enter Safe Mode and choose option 6, Initialize PS4 System. If your PS4 system can start up normally after initialization, you will be prompted to set up your system just like when you turned it on for the first time. Sign into your PlayStation Network account and go to the library to download game and video content that you've purchased from the PlayStation Store. At this point, you can also restore data that has been backed up to online storage and external USB devices. If initialization does not resolve your issue, then you should try Initialize PS4 System, Reinstall System Software. Follow this link for detailed instructions on downloading and installing the new installation system software. First, you'll need to download a special reinstallation version of the PS4 system software and store it on a USB storage device. Then you'll use Safe Mode Option 7 to install new system software after the PS4 has been initialized. Successful initialization will be followed by system setup and PlayStation Network sign-in as described previously. If your PS4 does not operate correctly after you've tried these Safe Mode options, please follow this link to learn how you can make a service request for your system.